Hey, how's it going, dude, you sulfurs?
Today I'm going to show you how you can use an AC manifold gauge set to diagnose problems with your car's AC system. But not just that, we'll also go over how you can use it to add refrigerant to your system as well. Alright, so on the left side we got this in blue. This is going to be for the low pressure side. And this gauge on the right side is going to be for our high pressure side. And then we got these two connectors at the end that will attach to the pressure ports on our high and low pressure lines of our AC system. And that's how we'll get the pressure readings on these gauges. And these guys are just attached to the manifolds at the ends here. And these don't do anything. They're just there so you can attach these to them. They have no practical purpose besides that. And the way these guys work is that there's a quick connect coupler at the end of them, which you pull out, and then you would put this over the pressure port. For this one's gonna be the low side pressure port. And then once you let it go, it holds it in place. And then you run down this valve. This valve here would press down on a Schrader valve that's on your connector for your low side and open up the system to your AC manifold gauges. All right, next let me explain to you what these two knobs here do, or actually in this case, this one knob. There's another knob that's supposed to be here just in red, but it's broken on mine and it's missing. Just imagine there's another knob like this here that's red. Once you open these will open up your low and pressure side to this center line, this yellow line. And this center line is used to add either refrigerant to your system or completely evacuate the system of refrigerant or pull a vacuum on the system after repair to confirm that there are no leaks in the system. Now, as far as where you attach your connectors, it's pretty easy. If you're lucky enough, you'll have a plastic cap like this that says H on it. And once you unscrew that, you'll see the pressure port where you would connect your high pressure side. But if you're not lucky enough to have those plastic caps, fear none. The connector that goes to the high pressure side is going to be, the diameter on the inside of it is going to be larger than the one that goes on the low pressure side. In so many words, these are basically dummy proof and you really can't put them on wrong. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and attach this to our high pressure side. After I attach it, you just want to pull on it slightly, make sure it's secured in place. And also before you put this on, you want to make sure your valve is turned counterclockwise all the way so that the pin is not going to press on the Schrader valve immediately. But then after you attach it, then you want to turn this clockwise so that the pin that's inside here presses on the Schrader valve. And there, I don't know if you guys heard it, but that just opened the system to our AC manifold gauge set. All right, so we come back up to our pressure gauges. And as you can see on the high side now, we have about 75 PSI of pressure on this side. And this is going to be considered your static pressure, which means this is the pressure you have with the car sitting, turned off, and the compressor not engaged. All right, next I'm gonna connect the low side, which is back here. All right, as you can see, we got about 60 PSI of pressure on the low side as well, which is pretty close to what we have on the high pressure side, and this is what you wanna see. All right, so on this board, I've drawn up two types of the common AC systems that are out there. One type is the one that has an expansion valve. The other type is the one that comes with an orifice tube instead. And what we have on this car is this system here. So we got our AC compressor, which is this guy here, which compresses the refrigerant and starts the high pressure side of your system, which goes from your AC compressor to your condenser, from there to your receiver dryer, and then your expansion valve. And then after that is the low side of your system, which is your evaporator, which is the one that's inside your dash, inside your car, with your blower motor inside there blowing over it. And then the return line that goes to your AC compressor. So this is the low pressure side on the system, and everything in red is gonna be your high pressure side. All right, so if you attach your pressure gauges to a car that's been sitting for a while, the pressure on both sides should be fairly close to equal, because once the compressor is turned off, the pressure equalizes on both sides. You know, the pressure leaks from the high pressure side to the low pressure side, and without the AC compressor running, one side is not gonna have more pressure than the other. But if you attach your pressure gauges and this side is a lot higher than the low side, then that means you have a clog here that's not letting the refrigerants to slowly get into the low pressure side, equalizing the system. And that usually the culprit for that is a clogged orifice tube if you have this system, or an expansion valve that's stuck closed. Now, unless you have a completely clogged orifice tube or an expansion valve that's stuck completely closed, it's not very common to have those numbers with the AC turned off and the car not running. Get in your car and turn on the engine. And turn on your fan all the way to high, make sure you're in maximum cool, and turn on your AC. Next, you want to wait a few minutes, and with your AC compressor clutch engaged, You want to take your measurements, and as you can see on the low side, we got about 15, 17 on the low side and about 120 on the high side.
All right, so next, once you get these numbers, you want to look into your repairs manual and compare those numbers to the numbers you're supposed to have given the temperature and the humidity at the time you took the measurements.
But here are some very general numbers that could guide you to try to diagnose problems with your car. All right, so here today, our temperature is about 68 degrees Fahrenheit, and our relative humidity is about 40%, and the pressure we're looking to get at the low side should be about 25 to 37, and the high side should be about 83 to 155.
All right, so according to the numbers we got earlier, we're definitely on the low side for the low pressure side, and also on the high pressure side, we're towards the lower side as well, which basically means we're simply low on refrigerant.
And that about sounds right, because on this car, when you turn on the AC, you don't get cold air, you just get slightly cooler coming out of your air vents.
All right, next let's talk about different numbers that you could get on your gauges. So if your numbers on the low side and on the high side are higher than what you're supposed to have, then that would indicate that you either have too much refrigerant in the system, or you could have air that has gotten in your system as well.
Also, if your AC condenser is unable to cool the refrigerant that's passing through it, either because your AC fans are not coming on, or junk and dirt and debris that could be lodged in front of it and not allowing air to pass over it, then again, you could potentially be high on both sides as well.
All right, next, let's say if you get about the same numbers on both sides. And if you're getting the same numbers on both sides with the air compressor running, in other words, your AC compressor clutch engaged, and you're still getting the same numbers, then that's gonna mean basically your compressor is not doing its job, which is basically to compress the refrigerant, to take refrigerant from one side, suck in refrigerant from the low side, and compress it into the high pressure side, creating low pressure on the low side and then a high pressure on the high side. And if it's not doing that, then that probably means it's shot and needs to be replaced. All right, so in the next scenario, we're gonna say that the numbers for your low side are lower than what they're supposed to be, and on the high side are higher than what they're supposed to be.
All right, so if that's the case, then you more than likely have a clog in your high pressure side, which is basically blocking the refrigerant from passing to the low pressure side, raising the pressure on the high side and lowering the pressure on the low side. The main culprit is going to be if you have a system with an expansion valve, the valve that's stuck near the closed position, or a clogged receiver dryer. Now, if you have a system that has an orifice tube instead of an expansion valve, then the main culprit is going to be the orifice tube. See, on this system, you don't have a receiver dryer on the high pressure side, but instead you have an AC accumulator on the low pressure side.
All right, so next let's talk about the trickiest set of numbers you can get while diagnosing an AC system, which is too high of a PSI on the low side and too low on the high side. If this is the case, and if you have an expansion valve set up, then that could potentially be your expansion valve that's stuck open or near the open position, allowing too much refrigerant to pass through, or a problem with the check valves inside your AC compressor. See these check valves, like on the low side, they only allow refrigerant to get in and not get back out, and on the compressor side or the high pressure side, they only allow refrigerant to get out and not get back in. But if like this check valve is not opening enough or it's kind of closed, then you're gonna build up too much PSI on this side, but more likely culprit is gonna be your expansion valve stuck near the open position. Now, if you get these numbers on a setup with an orifice tube, then see, it won't be your orifice tube, because an orifice tube just has a set opening or a set orifice, you could say, which only allow, you know, which is not adjustable, so it can't be stuck open like an expansion valve. So the culprit is going to be either your AC compressor or your AC accumulator, if it's clogged, would raise the pressure on the low side and therefore lower the pressure on the high side. All right, enough of that. So now let me show you how you can use this to add refrigerant to your car's AC system.
So obviously you'll need a can of refrigerant. You'll also need a can tap like this. And the way this works is that you'll screw this on the can, and then once you screw in this valve, there's a needle at the end of it that'll come out and puncture the can, opening up the refrigerant to the valve. And this is gonna be connected to this yellow line here, and then from here, we're gonna open up the valve to the low side, and then that's gonna suck in the refrigerant through this line and the can to the low pressure side. And once again, when you're screwing this on the can, make sure this valve is all the way turned counterclockwise and it's in the open position. And next we'll screw on our yellow line and then we start turning this in. All right, so once again, gonna get in the car, turn off the engine, then turn on the AC and come back here and open up that valve that will open up the system and suck in the refrigerant from the can through this yellow line and the blue line into the engine.
All right, so turn this counterclockwise. And you can turn this upside down to help with the flow.
And here's a closer shot, and you can actually see the refrigerant and all the oil that's in that can pass through here to your low pressure side. All right, with our can pretty much empty, we're at just about 25 on the low side and just above 150 on the high pressure side, which is about right.
And now we got really nice cold air coming out of these air vents. Awesome. And that should about cover it, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do me a favor and share it with your friends and family on your favorite social network, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And also join me there. I'll put a link to my pages on those networks or platforms right below this video. And especially on Instagram, I just opened my page there and I really like the platform there. So if you want to communicate with me on there and if you have an Instagram page, go ahead and add me there. I also put some links to other related videos on this side of the screen that you can click on. There'll also be links in the description box down below. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.